From where we are right now to where we will be many decades from now, join us as we discuss what will happen on Mars by 2058. Number 8. The state of colonies on Mars right now. Before we could look at the future of Mars, we honestly need to think about where we are with Mars right now, which is a work in progress, let's say. That's fair, right? In truth, the state of Mars right now is one of exploration and research. Scientists from NASA, SpaceX, and other fields in astronomy are working to get answers and information as to how humanity might live on Mars and what we can do once we land there. Both NASA and SpaceX are working on rockets that will enact the first manned missions to Mars, which is well ahead of where we were in the first decade of the 2000s. So that's indeed progress. Of course, none of this would have been possible without certain revelations about Mars, including that there is indeed water on it, which is going to be a very key factor in trying to make colonies work on the planet, as any supplies that would be brought would be very limited in number and in weight in order to ensure safe passage for the passengers on the shuttle. Speaking of which, both NASA and SpaceX are also working on enhanced rockets and shuttles to help ferry people to Mars, because this journey will be much longer and more intense than any manned mission in history. The moon voyage took only a couple of days to get there, and the same to get back, but this would take weeks, if not months, depending on final speeds. So as you can see, we still have a lot of research and information that needs to be found before even attempting to launch into space, because there are still many things we don't know, and what we don't know can kill us. But that doesn't mean that we can't learn and adjust as we go along, and when that time comes, things will be different. Number 7. 2022. In terms of getting to Mars, 2022 is a very important year for the very simple reason that this is when genius and stargazer Elon Musk wants to launch his first craft into space to go to populate Mars, which means that we're less than a few years away from this happening. That's quite soon when you really think about it. But what exactly is his mission? Will it be full-on colonization? Not quite. He has a more simple plan to start benefiting his rather genius intellect, because he knows that any mission to Mars that would involve colonization must first be done in steps, and the first step is to ensure that they can just reach Mars with his big Falcon rockets that he's got SpaceX working on. So what is the initial plan for 2022? Easy. He's going to send cargo ships of a sort to the Red Planet in the hopes that they'll both make it there and land on the planet with no issues. If that works, then he'll move on with the next phase of his plan. And of course, should something happen in flight, they can rejigger the rockets and shuttle that they have planned for the first manned flight to Mars and put the updates and fixes needed to ensure the flight safety on that one before launching it into space. There's also another hidden benefit to using cargo for the first flight. Mainly, they can still be working on advancements for their flights and their rockets in the meantime, because it's going to be a while before that second flight. So why stop working when you could make things even better? It may all seem a little complicated, but trust me when I say that when it comes to making things work in regards to space travel, you need to make sure that one part of the plan will work before ever risking a human life. Number 6. 2024. Okay, so let's assume that Elon Musk's plan works and his cargo ships reach Mars intact, and that the Mars weather and other conditions don't destroy the cargo themselves upon landing. What's next? Well, that would be people, but to be clear, he's not going to send a whole colony's worth of people in one go. That would be foolish and stupid and risky, and he knows that. So not unlike the cargo ships, he's going to send a limited amount of people to live on Mars for about 9 months in 2024. The goal of this first phase is simple. He wants to get the people to Mars, call that step one, and then see how they're able to interact on the planet, how well the cargo supplies hold up, and of course, set up the first home on the planet. Then see how things go over the course of time. Very methodical, isn't it? Well, that's what you need to do when you're colonizing a world, especially one that you've only really been looking at from afar. We can only speculate how we'd react on Mars because the only things we've sent there are rovers, probes, and satellites. And while they were very helpful in getting things like information and samples and occasionally rocks, they can't tell us how a human would react on Mars.
These first colonists are vital to understand if humanity can truly live on Mars and survive there long term, which is a key aspect of this whole venture. Elon Musk intends to have a livable base, generators that will run off various power sources on Mars to ensure they don't run out of power, and more. So they'll at the very least be able to last the first 9 months, barring something unforeseen, of course. Then once that's all taken care of, they'll fly back to Earth and be put under immediate observation. They'll be tested to see how their bodies have reacted to the Mars gravity and climate, see if there are any illnesses that can be detected. Are they malnourished or anything of the like? All this data helps both Musk and other space science institutions because that's data they honestly don't have right now, and it can influence any further missions to Mars. Oh, which SpaceX isn't the only ones planning for, and they'll be going about it in a slightly different way. But before we show you what that was exactly, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. That way you don't miss our weekly videos. Number 5. 2026. They say that competition breeds excellence, and that's true to an extent. And as such, when Elon Musk had previously announced his goal to go to Mars, he got himself a rival in the form of Mars One. Their goal was to launch by 2026, the first part of their own Mars mission. Like Musk, the first step in their mission was to send various kinds of equipment and cargo to go to Mars. Their plans were to go farther than Musk, though. They were going to send an entire habitat center for the astronauts to live in, and then give them solar panels for generators, satellites to establish communications and research, and even give them various kinds of tools to perform tests on Mars. It's all very elaborate, and it was clear that they were serious about the endeavor because they actually started sending out applications for those who might want to get a seat on the mission to Mars. Over 200,000 people applied for that. Think about that. 200,000 people were willing to go beyond Earth to a planet that is very inhospitable and try to live there despite all the dangers that were present. That honestly shows how much people want to colonize Mars, or at the very least, be part of something bigger, the colonization of the universe. Very romantic, I know. The problem, though, is that like many ventures that dare to dream, their dream got canceled, or in this case, shut down. As of 2019, the Mars One program was shut down due to lack of funding, which usually would be a deterrent for things like NASA and SpaceX, right? Wrong. It's only fueling them to go farther in their research and make sure that they can truly make their various timetables and try to establish colonies on Mars. Because if they don't, you can honestly say that no one will likely will. Number 4. 2026 to 2030. So one spacefaring mission to Mars is gone, but SpaceX is still in the running, as is NASA. But let's focus on Musk's plan for Mars colonization. So if he does make it to Mars with people in 2024 and is able to get them to stay on the planet without various issues for 9 months, gets the data he needs to ensure a longer-term trip to Mars, what then? Well, colony life begins. The goal of the second mission will be to help not just expand the colony, but help expand the potential of the colony, including giving them more materials and equipment to work with as they try and truly establish an everlasting colony on Mars. One of the ways that Elon Musk and company intend to do that is via space cranes. No, really, he wants to make cranes that'll be able to go up into space, grab equipment from the shuttles that orbit it, and then bring it down to the research base so that the colonies can use it. This would allow more speedy travel and less work for the colonists themselves. Not to mention, it would allow for the transport of heavier materials without the fear of losing them during flight. Plus, the cranes will be reusable for some time, ensuring their worth. How many people will be sent on these colonies is technically unknown, but I wouldn't put it past Musk to try and go 2 to 3 times the amount that he sent in the exploration trip, if you will. After all, the point of a colony is to have multiple people on it and thriving, and that's the mission of the second group. By this time, and through subsequent supply launches, the colony will grow in ways to make it seem more like a city. The homes that they'll have will be more elaborate. The food that they have won't just be from supplies that they get or procured, but ones they can likely grow themselves, the concept of which has already been proven. This will no doubt be refined by mission number 2. In many ways, the years surrounding mission number 2 will be the most important of the Mars missions so far. And not for just living there, but wanting to live there long term. Number 3. New life, new feelings on life. Something that we take for granted on Earth is that we have this familiar routine that we go through in our lives. Oftentimes, it's something like wake up, go to work, have lunch, go back to work, come home, do housework, relax, and go to sleep. It's simple. It's basic. It's how we do things on Earth. On Mars, though, that's not how things will be. Every day won't be the same to start because you're trying to build a colony, which is why the first couple of groups of people going to Mars will be ones who are specialists in their field and are picked to help further the colony. This gives them a purpose and helps them through some of the smaller moments of living on Mars, such as only seeing these people for the period of time that they are there, only having talks with their family via communications that'll take about 20 minutes to get from Earth to Mars, and vice versa. This isn't just a physical journey anymore. It's a mental one, an emotional one. And that can fuel what will happen as we go further with the idea of a human colony on Mars. The idea of doing it is simple and inspiring, but actually doing it long-term, living on a planet with only a few groups of people to start, that can be harrowing. But if we get through it, if we endure, then the future is upon to us. Number 2. 2050. 2050 is a big date in the minds of many people, including Elon Musk, because in the minds of scientists, astronomers, and more, 2050 is a year where we should not only be on Mars, but be starting to thrive on it. Musk himself has said that by 2050, we should be able to have a fully functioning city on Mars, as long as we've prepped ahead of time and have had no setbacks. And if that's the case, that would bring a whole new life for the human race. Granted, it's just a dream right now, but if it does happen, it would be a big moment and would set the stage for many years to come. Number 1. 2058. So we've made it to Mars. We've lived there for a couple of decades now, and life is actually pretty decent on it. Which brings us to the question we started the whole topic with. What will Mars be like by 2058? Obviously, this is all speculation, but that doesn't mean we can't have some fun speculating. First and foremost, barring unforeseen events like World War III, once we establish a colony on Mars that can thrive, we'll keep sending more people to make more colonies. So by 2058, it's very possible that we'll have full cities with thousands, if not tens of thousands of people living on Mars. And by that time, we'll have figured out how to build Martian cities, likely via domes like sci-fi movies and shows predicted, and how to power them via various energy sources. There's also the question of terraforming, or warping the planet to our needs. By 2058, we might have the ability to not just terraform the planet, but it could already be terraformed, so the red planet might not be so red anymore. There's even talks of using mirrored satellites to melt the polar ice caps and make oceans on Mars, which would obviously make things even better for the people living there. Finally, let's talk space travel. In 2019, it takes a long time to get from Earth to Mars, no matter what craft you're flying. But by 2058, we could potentially have space travel so fast that it'll be like a regular commute from your home to your work. Meaning not only will we be able to get to Mars quickly, people can go there for vacations. Or if you're on Mars and want to see friends on Earth, all you have to do is book a flight. The potential is limitless, but it all starts with a single step, and that's why many are trying to get us to Mars, so we can take that first step. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of these jumps into the future and how they relate to Mars? Do you think that we'll really be able to colonize Mars in full or in part by 2058? If not, when do you think we'll be able to do it? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.